Hello everyone. Have you ever thought why is the frequency 50 Hz or 60 Hz? Well, if you have, then you are at the right place. Let's take a look. There are two main reasons for it. The first one being history, where we'll go back to the 18th and 19th century to know what exactly happened. The second one being technical reasons to choose only 50 Hz or 60 Hz. Why are we doing that? So all of these things will be discussed. Please do watch till the end so that you'll be getting a fair amount of understanding of why only 50 Hz or 60 Hz is being used. So at the first place, generators play a very important role in power generation. Having said that, it also plays a very important role in deciding the frequency. Well, how exactly? In the initial days of invention of the light bulbs, a frequency of 133.33 Hz was used. In order to operate generators at 133.33 Hz, a 8-pole system was used. Well, wait, did I say poles? How are they related? The speed of the generator is actually given by n is equal to 120 f by p. For poles, p is equal to 8 and n is equal to 2000 rpm, we get f is equal to 133.33 Hz. Similarly, frequency of 25 Hz with 12 poles were used in Niagara project. 40 Hz frequency was used in the year 1891, and the experimentation was done with different frequencies, and it kept on continuing in the 18th and the 19th century. Finally, they came up with a conclusion that let us have standard frequency of 50 Hz and 60 Hz. British followed 50 Hz, US followed 60 Hz. Now the question is, why only 50 Hz or 60 Hz, isn't it? In order to understand this, let's take a look at the technical perspective. This diagram shows a typical thermal power generating plant. Turbines drive the generator through prime movers. The generator converts mechanical to electrical energy. The transformers are used to step up or step down the voltage levels. The power is transmitted through transmission lines. One important thing that needs to be observed here is if you have components like transformers, transmission line, distribution station, turbines, generators, etc., these components play a very important role in deciding the frequency. So while deciding the frequency, care has to be taken to consider the effect of each of these components for efficient operation. Alright, in order to understand this, let us consider the effect of frequency with transformer. The EMF induced in secondary of the transformer is given by E is equal to 4.44 f Na into B. Now, as the frequency is very high, if you are considering the frequency to be very high of 1000 Hz or 1500 Hz, higher will be the EMF induced, isn't it? Because they are directly proportional. Therefore, with lesser number of turns, we can achieve more voltage at the secondary. But why aren't we doing it then? It is because of the losses. So, hysteresis loss in a transformer is directly proportional to frequency, whereas eddy current loss is directly proportional to the square of the frequency. Therefore, as frequency increases, the losses also increases, and hence we go with an optimum value of frequency such as 50 Hz or 60 Hz. But why only 50 Hz or 60 Hz? As I mentioned previously, the turbine drives the generator as shown through a prime mover. We know that N is equal to 120 f by p. From studies, it was found that turbines was maximum at speeds with 3000 rpm to 3600 rpm. This should be achieved with minimum number of poles because the construction cost of the poles are very high, and hence this adds up to the overall cost of the system. So the objective is to reduce the number of poles. So with minimum number of poles, say for P is equal to 2 and the speed of 3000 rpm, we get F is equal to 50 Hz according to British standard. And hence for P is equal to 2, N is equal to 3600 rpm, we get F is equal to 60 Hz, that is according to US standard. This is why we choose 50 Hz or 60 Hz depending upon the country. Now the question is, why only two standards? This world contains a lot of countries, isn't it? Few of the countries are next to each other, separated by a border. For exchange of power between different countries, you need to have the same standard. Hence, finally it was decided, let's have two standards, that is 50 Hz or 60 Hz, and based on the geographical areas that you are located in, there will be exchange of power between different countries as well. And all of these are done only using two standards, that is 50 Hz and 60 Hz. If you like this video, please do like it, share it and subscribe to our channel for regular updates. Thank you and do watch out for my upcoming videos.